Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I apologize for the crappy lighting. It's 9:30 at night, it's dark. I just have these crazy bright fluorescent almost overhead lights in my kitchen to work with, so we're very washed out. But I wanted to share a couple things that I picked up today. I just got home from Boise. I spent the day with a couple friends of ours going shopping, picking up groceries, just doing some errands and things. It was so fun. But I wanted to share a little bit on what I picked up and why I picked up these specific things. January is here, the holidays are over. It's officially New Year, New Me season. Whatever, we've all been there, done that. But for the last week, I have been eating very differently than I usually do. If you know me personally, you know I am a sugar monster. I live off of sugar and caffeine and carbs, and that is how I get through most anything. It's just like feeding myself empty energy to keep going and then crash out. Obviously, that's not healthy. It's a lot of calories I don't need, and as such, we are a thick girl. And no shame to any thick girls out there. I will always be a thick girl, even if I lose weight, just because that's how my body is built and it does wonderful things for me anyway. However, I feel like I have reached a point where I just want to feel stronger and healthier and like I have more stamina and I'm not constantly trying to feed this cycle of burnout because I'm eating so poorly. For the last week, I've been doing this meal plan with my trainer, Jenny, and then my mom. We're all in a group text trying to hold each other accountable. But it's essentially like a whole 30 paleo keto had a baby type of thing. There's no sugar, there's no dairy, there's tons of veggies, some fruit, healthier carb options like sweet potatoes or multi-grain or sprouted breads, and all of those things that are off of the list are things that are major staples in my diet. So it's been very, very interesting to adjust to what I usually eat to fit this new plan. That being said, I'm 6 days in. We started on Monday, it's now Saturday, and I weighed myself this morning and I'm down 7 pounds. I was 198 when I started and I am 191 as of this morning. So I'm very excited and encouraged. I really hope that the progress keeps going. And with the success of this first week, I do feel much more encouraged to keep going with eating this way. Part of that is because in the next couple years, I want to be pregnant with or have baby number two. When I got pregnant with Charlie, I was 191 pounds. I gained 25 pounds with her during pregnancy and was back to my pre-pregnancy weight within a week of having her. However, my weight was always a discussion at appointments. It made me feel really terrible, like I was doing something wrong every time. And I know grand scheme of things, big picture, I really didn't gain that much weight at all. However, because I was a bigger girl to start with, I know that there was some concern about weight-related pregnancy complications, like preeclampsia. I was really, really good on my magnesium intake to help with that. I really just don't want to have to go through that again with baby number two. It was just really, really hard for me emotionally to go through that every appointment, especially towards the end when you're putting on weight so fast and you just got the side eye from your doctors every single time you weighed in and you're like, I'm doing my best. Like I can't help it. Like I'm eating so well and I'm doing all this activity and I'm just growing a tiny human and they are heavy. I want to avoid that. I want to avoid that. I also know that going into baby number two, I will have two babies. I will have a toddler or a small child to keep up with that I'll need to play with still and entertain and chase after and all of those kid things. And I'll also have this newborn that'll need me around the clock. And I don't know how I would do handling that right now. I think I would get through it, but I don't think it would go as well as if I was physically more prepared and if I was eating better and treating my body better than I am right now. And another thing with baby number two that I'm hoping doesn't happen is I got super bad pubic symphysis dysfunction with Charlie super early on. I was 20 weeks and my pelvic floor started to separate and it was so painful. I couldn't lift my legs more than 2 inches off the ground. I had to sit down to put on my pants because I couldn't lift my leg and bend over or even balance on one leg to put my leg in my pants. It was super hard, not only physically because it was really painful, but mentally it made me feel super incapable and kind of trapped in my own body. And I would like to do some work to help myself minimize that. I don't know if it's something that once you have it with one pregnancy, you have it for all of them. I don't know if even losing a bunch of weight would help, but from what I have read, it might. So I want to try it, and it couldn't hurt in general to just get rid of some extra weight that I don't need to carry around. All of that being said, I wanted to show you the groceries I picked up for week two. Today's grocery haul is from three stores. It's from Costco, the Boise Co-op, which is kind of like a bougie health food hippy dippy trippy kind of store, and then Walmart. Let's start with Costco. First, I picked up a bunch of bananas, a bunch of Honeycrisp apples, some assorted squashes and zucchinis, bell peppers, and cucumbers. All of these are like my favorite snacks right now. I picked up some almond butter. I've never actually had almond butter, so you'll have to tell me if it's good, but this is like the fancy, like just almonds in a jar type of almond butter that separates. So fingers crossed it's not gross, but that's what I'm allowed to eat, so yay. Picked up some Larissa's Kitchen organic beef jerky for protein filled snacks because I'm a very snacky lady. I've got two big flats of blackberries, three flats of organic raspberries, and three flats of big, giant, beautiful strawberries. Why do I have so many berries? Because my entire family is obsessed with berries. So I'll probably get to eat half of one of these in each berry flavor before they're gone between Danny and Charlie. I also got a flat of blueberries. We already had one in the fridge, so I didn't need to get that many of those. I got the Crystal Light variety pack with lemonade, cherry pomegranate, raspberry, and wild strawberry with caffeine. That is one I've had as a separate flavor and I love it. I've gone through two smaller packs already, so I figured why not get the big boy. The next items I got were from the Boise Co-op, which is that bougie health food hippy dippy trippy store. I got some superfine almond flour to make chocolate fat bombs with. Here's where the chocolate's coming from. Didn't have to get Ghirardelli, but I figured if I'm gonna be eating chocolate fat bombs, I might as well get the good chocolate. I got a yerba mate raspberry, one of my favorite flavors. For the fat bombs, I got a stevia sweetener. And then I also got Primal Kitchen Greek dressing and marinade, Primal Kitchen organic unsweetened ketchup, and their dairy-free ranch as well. I also, see if this actually tastes good, picked up this Good Karma plant-based sour cream. I've never had plant-based sour cream, so we'll see how that tastes. And then we went to Walmart. I picked up a couple things at the pharmacy I needed, but while I was there, I noticed they had a really big supply of Quest bars to choose from. So I picked up cookies and cream, chocolate peanut butter, chocolate brownie, and then chocolate chip cookie dough, and I was super, super hungry in the car, so I bit into one of those, and so far, this one's really good. While I was there, I also picked up some pens. These are my favorite types of pens to write with. I wanted some colored ones to do a couple things I wanted to try in my planner, so I got some of those, and then I got some colored dry erase markers for our new calendar on the wall. And then last but not least, I stopped by GNC. Danny was out of his stuff, so I picked up some Ghost Chips Ahoy protein for him, and then this Ghost pre-workout, and the flavor is Sonic Cherry Lemonade, so we'll see how that tastes. Hopefully he likes that. And while they were there, they also have Quest bars, and I saw this birthday cake one, so hopefully that one tastes good. I'm hoping that these bars are kind of a fun, quick snack for me on days where I'm just going. I don't have time to like make a protein filled snack. So between the Quest bars and the jerky and some fruit, I think I should be set up pretty well. As far as meat goes, I did pick up some turkey sausage. I know that there's probably a cleaner version, but this was at Costco and I figured why not try it. I also picked up these chicken teriyaki pineapple meatballs from Adel's. I love these. I could eat these for every meal. And when I looked at the sugar per serving, it wasn't terrible. So I picked up some more of these. I have another pack in the freezer. There it is. I picked up a bunch of chicken breasts in prepackaged containers. So there's two or three, depending on the weight per container there. Those will be easy to portion out for dinners and things. And then for Danny, definitely not for me. He loves these.
Tyson crispy chicken strips just for a quick meal. They're easy to pack for him for his lunches. So I got another bag of those as well.
Thank you guys so much for watching. If this health, I don't wanna say experiment because I want it to be long-term, but I also don't wanna shoot myself in the foot. If this health experience is something that you would like to continue to hear me share on, please let me know. I never want to bore anyone with my food or workout routine, but I also know that it's content I enjoy seeing what other people do. So if that's something that you'd like me to keep sharing on, please let me know. If planning for baby number two and the steps that I'm taking to hopefully make that an easier pregnancy than baby number one is of interest to you, please let me know. Either way, I'm so thankful that you were here watching today's video. Please leave a comment, just give it a like, share it with a friend, make sure you're subscribed, and I will see you next time. Bye.